بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters, we are living in a blessed time, a time with opportunities to have our sins forgiven and to be free from hellfire are plenty and are available for us every day, more than at any other time of the year. And especially, and we know that this time of the year is Ramadan. And now we are in the last 10 days of Ramadan, which is the best time of Ramadan. And the Prophet ﷺ used to worship Allah and increase in good deeds during the last 10 days and nights of Ramadan, more so than at any other time of the year. And one of the best acts of worship that we can do during this time is to make dua. And if we think about it, just the ability to make dua to Allah is a huge blessing upon us. If we imagine other faiths and other religions, they don't have the certainty or they don't have the knowledge that Allah is near to the one who calls upon Him. And that Allah loves to answer our dua. He loves for us to call upon Him. As Allah said in the Quran, "And when my servants ask you, O Muhammad, concerning me, indeed I am near. I respond to the supplication of the supplicant, or the one who calls upon me. So let them respond to me by being obedient to me, and believe in me that they may be rightly guided." So just to know that Allah is near to us when we ask upon Him, and that He answers the call of the caller when they call upon Him, is a huge blessing. And we are certain about this in Islam, and for anybody else who wishes to claim that they are certain in another religion, then they can bring their truths, or they can bring their proofs if they are truthful. And the reason dua is so special in Ramadan is because almost every single one of the reasons that we have to make our dua be closer to being accepted is available in Ramadan. Some of the examples are when the Prophet ﷺ said there are three supplications that are not rejected: the prayer of the father for his child, the prayer of the fasting person, and the prayer of the traveler. So we see that for the fasting, we see that the dua for the fasting person is not rejected. And alhamdulillah, in Ramadan, every day we are fasting. So every day we have a chance for our dua to be accepted. We also know that we can ask Allah, or we can make dua to Allah using the righteous actions that we have done in the past. As did the three who were stuck in the cave, the three men who were stuck in the cave, they each asked Allah, using the righteous actions that they had committed in the past, and Allah answered the dua, and He set them free from the cave. And in Ramadan, with our increased worship and increase in good deeds, then this is a great opportunity for us to use our good deeds to ask Allah to grant us forgiveness and to bless us in Ramadan and in all times of the year. There's also another opportunity for our dua to be accepted between the Adhan and the Iqama. As the Prophet ﷺ said, the dua offered between the Adhan and the Iqama is not rejected. Another opportunity is when we break our fast every day. The Prophet ﷺ said, indeed for the fasting person, at the time of breaking his fast, is a supplication that is not rejected. And again, we have another chance on Fridays to make dua. As the Prophet said, on Friday there's an hour when if a Muslim happens to pray at that time and ask Allah for something good, Allah will give it to him. And the scholars differed in opinion as to when exactly this hour is. Some said it is from the time when the Imam sits on the minbar until the end of the Friday prayer, and others said that it is after Asr until the last hour of Friday. So if one of us listens to the khutbah and says Ameen to the dua of the Imam and supplicates during the prayer, and when we are making sujood and prostration, and before the salam, before the end of the prayer, and also in the last hour of the day between Asr and Maghrib, then this is excellent, and this is this makes our dua more likely to be accepted. We also have the opportunity to make dua in prayer and in sujood. And the Prophet said that we are closest to Allah when we are prostrating to Allah, so that we should make as much dua as possible in sujood. And of course, in Ramadan, again, it is the time of the year when we are most engaged in prayer. We see that the masjid become full and people are striving to pray the obligatory prayers on time and in the masjid. And we're also striving to pray the recommended prayers, the sunnah prayers. We're also praying Tarawih at night. And now in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, we're also praying late at night, in the last third of night. So this is a lot of opportunities and many chances for us to make dua. We are making much more sujood at this time of the year than any other time of the year. So we should take opportunity of this. We should take advantage of this opportunity. And especially when we pray in the last third of the night, when Allah descends to the lowest heaven to bestow His bounty upon His slaves, to meet their needs and to relieve their distress, when He says, "Who will call upon me that I may answer him? And who will ask of me that I may give him? And who will seek my forgiveness that I may forgive him?" And this is in the last third of the night. And lastly, brothers and sisters, we have one of the greatest opportunities of the year, which is Laylatul Qadr, a night where Allah said that it is better than 1,000 months. And on this night, any act of worship that we do, any good deed that we do, has the chance to be rewarded, for as if we have done it for more than 1,000 months. As Allah said, Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. And the Prophet advised Aisha radiallahu anha to say from the Laylatul Qadr, Laylatul Qadr, Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni, which means, O Allah, you are forgiving and you love forgiveness, so forgive me. And it is important to know that Laylatul Qadr could be on any night of the last 10 nights of Ramadan. So we shouldn't confine it to only the odd nights or only the 27th night of Ramadan, because it can be on any night of the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And one who only worships Allah or increases in worship on the last 10 nights or on the 27th night might not get the reward that he wished for. He might not be granted the Laylatul Qadr, and this is a great loss, because this is one chance in a year, and we don't know if we will live to see the next year, to have Laylatul Qadr, the opportunity of standing in prayer, Laylatul Qadr, in the next year. So we should take advantage of the time that we have while we are alive. And with this, we ask Allah to bless us with worshipping Him on Laylatul Qadr, and to make it easy for us to increase in worship during the last 10 days. As we know, the racehorse, when it reaches the finish line, or when it approaches and comes near to the finish line, it increases its speed and exerts its maximum effort to reach the finish line, if not first, to the best time that it can possibly achieve. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ